Hello friends, my name is Tripti Mishra and I am your instructor for today. I will be discussing cybersecurity techniques part 1 with all of you. Now we are going to discuss another cybersecurity technique, that is antivirus. Before starting the discussion on antivirus, we should know the meaning of virus and other types of malwares. I'm assuming you all have already gone through virus, worms, Trojan horse, etc. in module 1 under section malware and its types. To revise the concept, what is a virus? Virus stands for vital information resources under C's. Computer viruses are small software programs that are designed to spread from one computer to another to interfere with computer operations. Virus can spread through attachments of funny images, greeting cards, audio or video files. A virus might corrupt or delete data on your computer. Keep one thing in mind, virus require human intervention. Types of virus. There are three different types of viruses: boot sector virus, program virus and macro virus. Boot sector viruses were most predominant viruses until mid-90s. They infect boot sectors on diskettes and hard disks. On diskettes, the boot sector normally contains code to load the operating system files. Then there are program viruses, the second type of computer viruses. They infect executable programs, usually .com and .exe files, but they sometimes also infect overlay files, device drivers, or even object files. Third is macro virus. Viruses which do not infect normal programs, but instead spread as macros in various types of files. A macro virus is a computer virus written in the same macro language used for software programs like Microsoft Excel, Microsoft Outlook, or word processors like MS Word. When a macro virus infects a software application, it causes a sequence of actions, generally to harm, to begin automatically when the application is open. This type of virus can easily spread through email when users unknowingly exchange infected documents. There are different types of malwares other than viruses, like Trojan horse, worms, scareware, adware, spyware. As we have already learned all these terms in module 1, let's just have a quick recap of their definitions. Trojan horse. It is a malicious code that is installed in the host machine by pretending to be useful software. The user clicks on the link or downloads the file which pretends to be useful file or software from legitimate source. It not only damages the host computer by manipulating the data, but also creates a backdoor in the host computer so that it could be controlled by a remote computer. Worms. They are a class of virus which can replicate themselves. They are different from the virus by the fact that they do not require human intervention to travel over the network and spread from one infected machine to the whole network. These are more dangerous than the viruses. Scareware. Internet has changed how we talk, shop, play, and a lot more. It has even changed the way how the criminal target the people for ransom. While surfing the internet, suddenly a pop-up alert appears in the screen which warns the presence of dangerous virus, spyware, etc. in the user's computer. As a remedial measure, the message suggests to download the full paid version of the software. As the user proceeds to download, a malicious code known as scareware is downloaded in the host computer. It holds the host computer hostage until some ransom is paid. The malicious code can neither be uninstalled nor can the computer be used till the ransom is paid. Adware. It is a special type of malware which is used for forced advertising. They either redirect the page to some advertising page or pop up an additional page which promotes some product or event. Spyware. It is a special type which is installed in the target computer with or without the user permission and is designed to steal sensitive information from the target machine. Mostly it gathers the browsing habits of the user and send it to the remote server without the knowledge of the owner of the computer. Keylogger is the best example of spyware. It can be used by criminals to steal information and used by law enforcement to grab a criminal. Now the question arises that from where these viruses come from. Basically, a virus is a malicious code that is designed by an individual with the motive to create problems and troubles for others. Some people create viruses and malware because they enjoy causing trouble and making others suffer. Biological viruses are created by their own, but computer viruses are deliberately created by programmers or people. How do viruses spread? Viruses are most easily spread by attachments in email messages or instant messaging messages. This is why it is essential that you never open email attachments unless you know who it is from or from whom you are expecting it. A virus is an infected system which may send a web address link as a message to other contacting system. Thinking the link is from a friend, the recipient may sometimes follow the link and virus spreads in that system also. Viruses also spread through downloads from the internet. They can be hidden in illicit software or other files or programs you might download. A virus can copy itself and infect a computer without permission or knowledge of the user. A virus cannot be spread without human action. That is, if you have received a file that is infected but you have not opened it, then in that case, virus will not spread in your system. Viruses can also be spread through removable media like floppy disk, pen drive, hard drive, CD, USB drive, etc. Can you all jot down few damages done by viruses? Let me help you with a few. Sometimes display unwanted messages that irritates the user. It can clog computer memory and sometimes system crashes. It can delete the files, format hard drives that lead to the loss of data. For example, let's say an Indian hacks a Pakistani website and displays Jai Hind on it. The damage caused by these viruses varies from minor delays in computer function to complete destruction of your hard drive. For companies, the price is far higher. A downed website can cost a company millions of dollars a day. Viruses are written for vandalism, which is an action involving deliberate destruction of or damage to public or private property, to attack the products of specific companies, to distribute political messages, and financial gain from identity theft. What would you do if you find that your system has a virus? If you find that your system has a virus, clean your computer with antivirus software. We will discuss antivirus in detail in further slides. If your computer is still not working properly, consider hiring a trusted expert who can recover your data. Data can be successfully extracted from corrupted hard drive, but it is a complex process that will require another computer, special software, and a technician with experience in data recovery. Remember, nothing gives you 100% security. But by using antivirus software and firewall, we can improve our computer security up to some extent. You can continue to improve your computer security and decrease the possibility of infection by using a firewall. Keeping your system up to date, maintaining a current antivirus software subscription, and follow some practices. How to prevent system from computer viruses? First, do not open emails and email attachments if received from unknown and untrusted sources. Ensure that you examine and scan email and other attachments before they run, as they might contain viruses. For example, download a mobile application from a trusted source only. Second, avoid downloading files, games, screensavers, etc. from unsecure websites. Be sure that the source is a legitimate and reputable one. For example, do not download songs from insecure websites that redirect you to some adverts, etc. Third, use different antivirus softwares and keep your antivirus updated. Note, purchase a licensed version of an antivirus having a key. Fourth, configure your antivirus software to boot automatically on startup and run at all times. If you are not using updated antivirus, variations of viruses and new ones can be skipped to check. In continuation to the previous slide, take care using USB flashcards, CDs, floppy disk and external hard drives. The more flashcards, CDs, floppies, hard drives have been used on, the better the chance of virus infecting them, so clean them before use. If your computer is on network, make sure you have security steps in place to prevent unauthorized users putting files on your computer. Antivirus. Antivirus is a computer program that is used to identify and eliminate computer viruses, like penicillin used as an antibiotic for human body. Similarly, antivirus acts as a guard for your system. They scan all files and applications and clean up the unwanted viruses that are harmful to your system. Antivirus software is considered to be an aid that detects, fixes, and even prevents viruses and worms from spreading to your computer as well as connecting computers. After installing an antivirus, you should scan your system periodically. Always keep your antivirus running so that it can provide constant protection. We can scan our files or system in two ways, automatic scan or manual scan. In automatic scan, it automatically scans the files or directories at specific intervals of time. The other way to scan the files or directories or system is manual scan. In this, saving and scanning email attachments or web downloads rather than selecting the option to open them directly from the source is done. Scanning floppy disks, CDs, DVDs, hard drives for viruses before opening any of the files is also done through this scan. Working of antivirus. Antivirus applications maintain a database of known viruses and compare scanned files that match the characteristics of known viruses. If a scanned file matches those characteristics of known viruses, it is quarantined, which means moved to a new, presumably safe location on a disk and renamed so you can find it if you ever need it, so that it cannot affect other files on your system. Antivirus scans files or your computer's memory for certain patterns that may indicate an infection. The patterns it looks for are based on the signatures or fingerprints of known viruses. Once the virus is detected in the wild, the antivirus companies then release the new patterns for your antivirus software to use. These updates come out daily by some vendors. Virus authors are continually releasing new and updated viruses. So it is important that you have the latest definitions installed on your computer. Signature detection is just one way of identifying viruses and is only effective if the virus database is up to date and contains the signature of virus. Antivirus programs also attempt to identify suspicious behavior that include an application attempting to write to an executable file, altering needed system files, making suspicious registry entries, or adding to the list of items that execute automatically upon system startup. Once the file is quarantined, the application can attempt to repair it, delete it, or prompt you for a decision on what do you want to do about the file that is infected. In this figure, you can see that whenever an antivirus detects a malicious code, it asks to perform the action, whether to keep it or remove that file. This is the block diagram that represents the working of an antivirus software. The information starts from the source system and must reach to the destination system. Source system could be anything like floppy disk, hard drive, etc. And destination system could be hard drive of a computer or an ISP, Internet Service Provider, which stores the message, sends them when a client requires. The information interpretation system varies depending upon a special mechanism or whether it is implemented in operating system. This interpretation mechanism is specific for each OS or depending on component in which antivirus program is implemented. For example, in Windows 8, a virtual driver is used which monitors the activity of disks. Therefore, every time the information is accessed through floppy disk or hard drive, then antivirus program will intercept the read and write call to the disk and then scan the information so that anybody can read it safely. All these operations work through the kernel in Windows XP/2000. All antivirus softwares have different interpretation mechanism. It is not only made for the OS, but also other applications. Sometimes interpretation mechanism is not available by the antivirus program or by any application. So it uses other resources. Resources that secretly take information and pass it to the antivirus, and then it scans the information and disinfects the file. Once the information has been scanned using any method, then two operations are performed. First, the clean information is sent to the interpretation phase so that it can continue towards the destination system. Second, alert message is sent to the user interface. User interface can vary. For example, in an antivirus of workstations, the message can be displayed on the screen directly, and an antivirus for server, the alert message could be sent to the mailbox. A lot of antivirus softwares are available in the market. Some of them are Bitdefender, Kaspersky, Panda, McAfee, QuickHeal, Avira, Avast, Norton, and a lot more. You can see the logos of various antiviruses available in the market. The last cybersecurity technique that I am going to discuss is firewall. You might have heard this term when I was discussing about viruses and antiviruses. A firewall is a system designed to prevent unauthorized access to or from a private network. Firewalls can be implemented in both hardware and software, or a combination of both. A firewall is a security policy enforcement point that regulates access between computer networks. Filters are inherently insecure services. Firewalls control TCP protocols, HTTP, SMTP, FTP, Telnet, etc. It is only one of many different security tools to control and regulate network traffic. What do firewalls protect? Firewalls protect not only data, but also resources and reputation. Data covers proprietary corporate information, financial information, and sensitive employee or customer data. Resources covers computing resources and time resources. And reputation covers loss of confidence in an organization, or intruders uses an organization's network to attack other sites. There are various applications of firewall. Like, firewalls are used to defend resources, to validate access, to manage and control the network traffic, to record and report on events, and act as an intermediary between internal and external network. Now, firewalls protect an individual or organization from internal users. Why? Okay, tell me, if any student just for fun creates a virus and install on all the systems in the computer labs, what would happen? Or if an employee who is unhappy with his organization just before leaving the organization writes an e-bomb that would activate on a particular date after he leaves the organization, what would happen? Just think of it. Then, firewalls also protect the organization from the hackers. Corporate espionage, which is a practice of spying and monitoring the activities of employee in an organization. It also protects from terrorist activities and common thieves. Basic components of firewall. Firewall comprises the following: policy, advanced authentication, packet inspection, and application gateways. Just purchasing a good firewall is not sufficient. One must configure it properly, keeping the security objective in their minds. Operation of firewall. There are two access denial methodologies used by firewall. A firewall may allow all traffic through unless it meets certain criteria, or it may deny all traffic unless it meets a certain criteria, as you can see in the figure. The type of criteria used to determine whether the traffic should be allowed through varies from one type of firewall to another. Firewalls may be concerned with the type of traffic or with source or destination address and ports. They may also use complex rule bases that analyze the application data to determine if the traffic should be allowed through or not. How a firewall determines what traffic to let through depends on which network layer it operates at. Problems that firewalls cannot fix. There are few things that even the firewall cannot fix, like many email hacks, vulnerabilities in application protocols you allow, for example, incoming HTTP requests to an IIS server, modems. Don't allow users on the internal network to use a modem in their machine to connect to an external ISP to connect to the internet. This exposes everything that user is connected to the external network. Many users don't like the restrictions that firewall places on them and will try to subvert those restrictions. I hope you might have understood the need of cybersecurity and information security. Also, I believe that you might have understood the cybersecurity techniques that I covered, namely authentication, antivirus, and firewall, and will be able to use them in real life to prevent cybercrimes. All these cybersecurity techniques are important to secure system and thereby data, not only in digital but physical form as well. Use effective and efficient authentication mechanism to secure your computer system from unauthorized access. Use licensed antiviruses to secure your computer system from malwares. And use system firewall to protect the system from insider as well as outsider threats. Thank you, and keep yourselves updated with upcoming threats and vulnerabilities in the market. Follow GB Hackers or The Hackers News for this purpose.